गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड। तो इन द यस्टरडेज लेक्चर वी हैव सीन वी हैव कवर्ड फर्स्ट टू यूनिट्स। नाउ लेट अस गो फॉर द थर्ड यूनिट। सो फॉर थर्ड यूनिट लेट मी शेयर द स्क्रीन सो दैट यू कैन एबल टू सी व्हाट इज देयर ऑन द थर्ड यूनिट। So what is the topic name? Numerical integration and solution of ordinary differential equation. So here what is a numerical integration? General problem of numerical integration can be stated as, okay, we are having the set of tabulated values. With the help of that, we have to find out the integration. And that is also definite integration, where we define integration if upper and lower limit of the integrations are provided, that is a and b. If it is not provided, then it is not a definite integration, okay? The next, now let us go for having Newton's forward difference interpolation formula. With the help of having a Newton's forward difference interpolation formula, what is the formula? Y naught plus P delta Y naught plus P P minus 1 delta Y naught delta square Y naught divided by 2 factorial. Next is P P minus 1 P minus 2 divided by 3 factorial into delta cube Y naught and so on. Okay, so here, what we have done, we have in closed interval AB. This closed interval AB we have divided into the equal sub intervals. Okay, for that we have divided. So x0, x1 up to xn. Okay, so from x0 to xn, instead of saying the integration from A to B, we are saying from x0 to xn. Next is we have P is equal to x minus x0 divided by h. What will be dp is equal to derivative of p dp is nothing but dx. Why? Because x0 and h both are fixed out. What is x0? It is the initial value of x. And what is h? H is the difference between the two consecutive values of x. Okay. So as h is fixed out, because we are studying the with the help of Newton's forward difference interpolation formula. And Newton's forward and difference forward and backward interpolation formula is useful only if values of x are equally distributed. Okay. Now, instead of saying from x0 to xn, we are writing it from 0 to n. Okay. Now, after finding the integration, what will be the integration with respect to p? You can have here dp is equal to dx. So, what are the limits of integration x0 to xn? Okay. Now, if I put x0 is equal to x0 here, x0 minus x0 will be 0. So, value of p will be 0. So, upper lower limit x0 is changed to 0. Now, what is xn? So, xn minus x0. What will be xn minus x0 divided by h is nothing but p. What will be xn minus x0? That will be n into h. Okay. Why this is n into h? Because if you remember forward difference formula in which we have written xn is equal to x0 plus n times h. So what will be, whenever you are having x, put xn, because we have to change the limits of integration also, no? So here lower limit is now changed to 0. If you put x is equal to x0, x0 minus x0 will be 0. What is upper limit? Xn minus x0 divided by h will be n into h divided by h. H is get cancelled, will have upper limit is n. Okay. So here dx is now changed to dp. Now we have to find out the values. Okay. So what is the integration? Integration of y naught is with respect to dp. Why this is h? Because where this h we have found. This h we have substituted here. So hence, now what will be the value? Dp is not, dx is nothing but h times dp. H times dp we have written. Now after finding the integration, what will be this? Minus into p plus y, delta y naught as it is p square by 2. As we are, if the integration is with respect to p. So hence 1 upon 2 factorial, then p square, p square. The integration of p square is p cube by 3. Integration of p is p square by 2 and so on. So what are the limits of integration now? 0 to n. Now if I keep h outside, now just put up the limits of integration wherever you are having p, just put n. n minus, wherever you are having p, just put 0. Then after putting all this, you will get the value. So this is nothing but if you keep n outside, n into h, and you will get the inside the bracket this value of this value. Okay, what is the value? Y naught plus n into delta y naught by 2 plus n into a 2n minus 1, 2n minus 3 divided by 2l delta cube y naught and so on. So this is what a general formula for numerical integration. Also, it is called as a Newton's code general integration formula. Okay. Now we have to find out what will be the effect of this integration formula for putting the values of n equal to 1, 2, 3, and so on. Okay. Have you understood what we have done? First, we have to find out integration, that is definite integration within the closed interval AB. Now, this closed interval AB we have divided into n equal part. So, xn is equal to x0 plus n into h. So, forward in backward difference interpolation formula useful only if the our values of x are equally distributed. Okay. So, instead of writing now integration within the limits a to b, we have written from x0 to xn. Okay. So, what is y dx? Now, this formula y is nothing whatever we have written with, this is nothing but with the, how to find out y? That is nothing but our, with the help of our Newton's forward interpolation formula. Okay. So y of x should coincide with b of x. We are finding a new polynomial which coincides with the original one, such that f of xi should be equal to y of xi. So how to find out y? Y is with the help of Newton's forward difference interpolation formula. Now just we have to find out that this px we have to change to dp. So this p into h is equal to x minus x naught. Okay. So what will be dx? Dx is nothing but h into p, h into dp. And limits of integrations are also changing because whenever you are having the lower limit, x naught minus x naught will be 0. So p into h is equal to 0. So what is the lower limit is 0. Upper limit xn minus x naught divided by h. What is xn? Xn minus x naught you will get here. You can see it is a n into h. So hh get cancelled, we'll get n. So upper limit is n. Now just you have to evaluate the integration with respect to p. H is constant we have taken outside, so just evaluate the integration with respect to p. Here there is nothing, so integration with integration dp will be p. Integration of p is p square by 2. Integration of p square is p cube by 3, and so on. After that, just put up the limits of integration 0 to n. Okay, after putting the lower and upper limit, we can get this result. This is a general integration formula. Now we are going to discuss the cases. That is a first rule, that is a trapezoidal rule. Okay. So in this case, we have to put n is equal to 1. If I put n is equal to 1, what will be the integration? N into h. So instead of n, n is 1. So we are having integration I is equal to h y naught plus delta y naught by 2. N is 1. So what will be the value if n is 1? So we are getting simply the two terms, that is y naught plus 1 by 2 delta y naught. Next, x1 to x2 again we'll get y2 y1 and so on. Now this we have to combine all those and we'll get the formula for trapezoidal. Okay. What you get is first we have to obtain x0 to x1. What will be this? H as it is y0 plus 1 by 2 delta y0. So what is the value of delta y0? Delta y0 we have written y1 minus y0. So 1 by 2 y1 minus y0. 1 by 2 y1 minus y naught by 2. Okay. Now just here is y naught, here is minus y naught by 2. So it will be y1 by 2 plus y naught by 2. So what I get is h into y1 plus y naught divided by 2. Similarly, you can have the second, that is integration. Now we are taking within the limits x1 to x2, that is h by 2 y1 plus y2. Similarly, if integration within the limits xn minus 1, xn. So that is h by 2 yn plus yn minus 1. Now, combining all the integrations, we'll get the general formula. Okay. So what is the general formula? First, we have found this value, second, third, and so on. Combining all these, we can keep h by 2 outside. What we remains in the bracket y0 plus y1 by 2 y3 up to yn. Okay. So here these terms are repeating. What are those terms which are repeating? Here you can have y naught plus 2y1. y1 is repeating here, y2 is also repeating up to yn minus 1. So those term we are repeating, we are keep it in bracket 2 times y1, y2, y3 up to yn minus 1. Okay, so hence you can get have a trapezoidal formula. Similarly, we can have Simpson's 1/3 rule. So in this 1/3 rule, what we are going to do, we are going to have a value n equal to 2. Wherever you are having a general formula for integration. What is a general formula for integration? Here this is a general formula. So here you have to put n equal to 2. Just now we have written here, we have to discuss the cases when n is equal to 1, 2 and so on. If you put n equal to 1 in the general integration formula, you will get trapezoidal rule. And if you put n equal to 2, you will get the Simpson 1/3 rule. Okay, so here we have to integrate within the limits x0 to x2. Okay, so wherever you are having n equal to n, we are having n equal to 2. So just put up all those values, you will get y0 plus delta y0 plus 1 by 2 delta square y0. And this 2 get cancelled, here this 1 by 6. And then put up the value of delta y0, that is y1 minus y0. What is the value of a what is the value of delta square y0 is y2 plus 2 minus 2y1 plus y0. So we will get integration from x0 to x1 is h by 3 y0 plus 4y1 plus y2. Similarly, we have to find out now up to x2 we have found. Now we have to find out x2 to x4. Similarly, xn minus 2 to xn. So combining all those, now we can write the general formula. Now taking all the common terms, you can have these are the common terms y0 as it is, and here 4 times y1, y2, y5, all the odd terms, 2 times all the even terms y2, y4, yn minus 2. That is, if suffixes are even, 2 times, and if suffixes are odd, then it is 4 times. And the last term is yn, that is called the Simpson's 1/3 rule. And if you put n equal to 3 in the general formula, you will get the Simpson's 3/8 rule. Okay. So again, we have to do the same procedure, put n equal to 3, then it is x0 to x3. Here n is 3. Wherever you having n, you have to put n equal to 3 in the general error formula. Then finally, we'll get the result. After some calculation, you have to just combine all this. And wherever you are having y1, y2, y4, y5, it is 3 times. Plus 2 times y3, y6 and so on. Whatever may be the multiple of 3, it is 2 times. And here we have 3 times y1, y2, y5 and so on. And the last term is y. Okay. So these are the general integration formula, trapezoidal rule, Simpson 1/3 and 3/8 rule. Now, as I told you that what are the geometric interpretation of all these rules. Okay. As we have already discussed that, what is a trapezoidal rule? Okay, what is trapezoidal rule? The name itself suggests that we are going to find out the area of integration within the limit. So we have area of integration with the help of trapezium. Okay, whatever you are having a curve, as you can see, we are having y is equal to some. You can go for the trapezoidal rule. We have the some function y, right? Now here we are having some function. Area integration is within the limit x0 to xn y dx. So y is some function. So you have to find out the area of integration of that function. If I want to find out the integration, that is nothing but the area under the curve. Integration is nothing but the area under the given curve. What is a curve? Y is equal to some function is a given. That function you have to plot and you have to find out the area under that curve. Okay. After plotting the function, that is nothing but the integration meaning. So here, what is the meaning of trapezoidal rule? So in the trapezoidal rule, what we will do, yeah, whatever the function we have, now here we will get the general formula for the integration. So whatever we are getting the general formula for trapezoidal rule, wherever you are having y, we'll get some function. So area of whatever the integration we are solving, that is with the help of this formula, that is h by 2 y naught plus 2 y 1 plus y 2 plus up to so on y n minus 1 plus y n. So this is a formula simply. What is the meaning of trapezoidal rule? Whatever the function we are having, whatever the curve we are having, this curve we are going to divide in the form of the trapezium. Okay, I think everyone know about the trapezium. Okay, so this curve we are going to divide in the form of trapezium. Now after dividing, you can find out the area under the curve with the area of a trapezium. Okay, after finding the area of a trapezium, now combine all the add all the areas of trapezium and then you can get the area of the area under the curve. That is nothing but the meaning of the integration. Now what is there in the Simpson's one third rule? Here also this rule is obtained by putting n equal to 2. So this rule is not exactly true whenever you are finding the area of integration. So whenever you are having the question, go with the Simpson 3/8 rule, because this rule will give you the more approximate answers. Okay, so it will give you the exact result with the at least 3 degree polynomial. Okay, so here we have to find out the examples that we will solve in the next lectures. Okay. Let me share you the screen of that workbook. Let us go with one by one procedure. But we have general integration formula. Capital I is equal to integration 0 to x naught to xn. What is the Newton's forward difference interpolation formula? That is y naught plus p y naught p delta y naught plus p into p minus 1 delta square y naught divided by 2 factorial plus p into p minus 1 p minus 2 divided by 3 factorial into delta cube y naught and so on. This is the Newton's forward difference interpolation formula. So what we have, integration x naught to xn y dx. So this is dx. Okay. So now here we have x minus x naught divided by h is nothing but p. So that is, we can write it as x minus x naught is equals to p into h. So what will be dx derivative? That is nothing but h as it is dp. So hence we can write integration is equals to, now if I put x is equal to x naught here, x naught minus x naught will be 0. So lower limit will be 0 if I put x naught. If I put xn, what will be this? Xn minus x naught. Okay. So here I will write this is x naught minus x naught will be 0. Xn minus x naught. What will be xn minus x naught? That is nothing but n into h. So this hh get cancelled. What I get is simply n. The upper limit is n, lower limit is 0. So after integration, what will be the value? So if I keep this h outside, what I get is y naught plus p into delta y naught plus p p minus 1 and so on. Okay. So after this, what is the integration? Integration I is equals to 0 to n. Let me solve the integration itself. So y naught p. Okay. Okay, what I get the integration is y naught p, h is outside, y naught p plus p square by 2 delta y naught plus next is p cube by 3 p square by 2. And here is 1 by 3 factorial delta cube y naught and so on. And we have to put this is within the limits 0 to n. So wherever you are having put n. So you will get h in y naught n plus p square by 2 factorial delta square y naught plus p minus. Wherever you are having p, if you put p is equals to 0, you will get the result. So this is what a general error formula. You can evaluate this or unless you can keep it as it is. Okay, now let us go for what is a trapezoid. Okay, we are having suppose a curve y is equal to some function is given. No, you have to find out the integration of this function I close interval a b y dx. Okay, y काहीतरी फंक्शन असेल ना दिस विल बी सम फंक्शन वाय सो लेट अस ड्रॉ दिस सपोज यू आर हैविंग दिस फंक्शन व्हाट यू विल डू यू हैव टू डिवाइड दिस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ ट्रॅपेझियम ओके आई होप यू आर गेटिंग यू हैव टू डिवाइड इट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ सम ट्रॅपेझियम्स एंड फाइंड आउट द एरिया ऑफ ऑल दोस ट्रॅपेझियम्स Find out the area of all those trapezium at their areas. This is A1, A2, A3 and so on. If I am adding all those areas, I will get the area under the curve. That is integration is nothing but the area under the given curve. And why it is name is trapezium rule? Because we are going to divide our given area in the form of trapezium. You have to just find out the area of all the trapezium and add them and you will get the area under the curve. That is nothing but the integration. Okay. So let me go for the one example of this with the help of a trapezoidal tool. Okay. But we have integration 0 to 1. We have to solve 1 upon 1 plus x square dx by using trapezoidal rule. What is given to us? We have a one table. We are provided with values of x and y as 0, 1, x and y. What is the value of x is 0, next is 0.5, next is 1. And corresponding value of y is 1, 1.8 and 0.5. Okay, so these are the things given to us. We have to solve this example by using the trapezoid rule. As it is within the limit 0 to 1, you have to find out integration 0 to 1 by dx is equal to what is the formula we have? H by 2 y naught plus times y1 plus y2. Okay, here we are having value of n is 2 only now because we have this is our x0, this is x1, this is x2. So value of n is 2. So for wherever you are having trapezoidal formula, general formula for trapezoidal rule, put n equal to 2. Okay, so after putting n equal to 2 because we are having only x0, x1 and x2. Corresponding values are y0, y1 and y2. Okay, so hence we are getting this. We will write the h. What is our value of h is? Difference between two consecutive values of x is 0.5 divided by 2. What is y0? We have y0 is 1 plus 2 times. What is the value of y1 is 0.8. Yes, value of y2 is 0.5. Okay, after calculating this on a KLC, you can get the result is 0.775. Okay, so in this way, you have to solve the examples. Now let me show you whatever we have on the actually the in detail description is given why it is called trapezoidal rule 1/3 and which rule is good. I hope everyone is reading this introductory numerical analysis book. Recommended book for you is Introductory Methods of Numerical Analysis by S.S. Sastry. I hope everyone is reading this. Solve the examples from exercise examples are there. Many examples are solved also. So let me go for that our interpolation we have done. Many examples are solved. That's why I'm sharing this book, so that those who haven't seen it, you can see the many examples are solved, many exercises are given, and in detail is every example given. So on the page number 201 we have it. In the chapter number 5, you can have numerical integration and differentiation. Both is given to you. Okay, numerical differentiation is also given, Newton's forward difference formula. With the help of this, you have to find out numerical differentiations. And let me go for our Simpson's rule, general integration formula. Here we have numerical integration. What is a numerical integration? We have set of n plus 1 values are given, and how to find out the integration within the limits a to b. Now this integration, a closed interval a b, have been divided into n equal sub intervals. Okay, n equal sub intervals such that a is equal to x naught and b is equal to xn, and in this conditions are all the values of x are equally distributed. That is, difference between all the values of x is either is fixed. If it is 1, so it should be difference between every consecutive values should be 1. If it is 2, the difference between every consecutive values of x should be 1. So now here what we have done is, here you can see dx is equal to htp, the limits of integration have been changed. So this is the general formula. Now here trapezoidal rule we are using for n equal to 1, that is from x0 to x1. Next is x1 to x2, next xn minus up to xn. So here we have found this general formula. So this is so here you can see geometric significance of this rule is that y is equal to x is divided by n straight lines. So joining the points x0, x1, x0, x1, y1 and so on. Okay, so area bounded by the curve then approximately equal to sum of the area. Sorry for that. Actually, we have to find out the trapezoidal rule. No? N is straight line joining the points x naught x naught y naught xn yn x1 y1 and x2 y2. So in this way, we have to find out area bounded by the curve y is equal to f of x. Okay. What are the coordinates we have? we have to join the points x naught x y x naught y naught x1 y1. Correct. I don't know exactly where will be those points. We have to join those points with the help of n straight lines. Okay. We have to join the point x1 y1 with x2 y2. So somewhere you are getting it like a trapezium, and then area bounded by the curve we have to find out with the help of the those n trapeziums we are obtaining. Sum of the areas of n trapezium. The area of error in the trapezoidal rule can be found by this error formula. We will see later on. So here you can see this is our Simpson's one third rule. So in the Simpson's one third rule, what you have to put n is equal to 2 in the general formula, and you will get the result. And this is a error in Simpson one third after one third, it is 3/8 rule. So this is not accurate as a Simpson's rule. Instead of saying Simpson one third, you can say it is Simpson's rule simply. So Simpson one third rule is more accurate than Simpson's 3/8 rule. Okay, these are the things we have to discuss. Thank you. Stop the lecture.